Morning friends, welcome to session 33 of chapter Direct and Inverse Proportion. Okay, so far we have done 7 problems of exercise 10.1. Today we will get into the remaining 4 problems. Okay, so let's start. So first one, if the weight of 12 sheets of thick paper is 40 grams, let us write the solution. Given weight of 12 sheets of thick paper is 40 grams. Next, what is saying? How many sheets of the same paper would weigh 16 2 by 3 kilograms? How many sheets is saying? So let us assume that X sheets. Okay, next. Weight of X sheets of same thick paper is 16 2 by 3 kilograms. Got it right? So he's saying that weight of 12 sheets of thick paper is 40 grams, and how many thick papers will weigh 16 2 by 3 kilograms? So we don't know how many. So let us assume that as X. So now let's see what he's asking. Okay, we need to find out this X. So let us write this in a tabular form. Okay. So, I am taking two columns, one is weight, the other one is sheets, weights and sheets. Okay, first, weight 40 grams, how many? 12 sheets. 40 grams, 12 sheets. Next, 16 2 by 3 kilograms, which is nothing but kg, okay? 16 2 by 3 kilograms, how many? As we don't know, we assume it as X. Now, see, this is in grams, so we need to convert this kgs also into grams. So 16 2 by 3 kgs, we can write as 16 2 by 3. How can we write this one? 316 is 48. 48 plus 2 50, which is equal to 50 by 3 kilograms. Right? This should be converted to grams. So, as we know, 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. 50 by 3 kg is equal to 50 by 3 into 1000, which will be 50 into 1000 is 50,000 by 3 grams, right? This should be rough work. Okay, 50,000 by 3 grams. So the 16 2 by 3 kgs should be is equal to 50,000 by 3 grams, right? Now, so what we will do now? We'll need to do cross multiplication, right? Okay. Now this will be, or you can write x1, y1 formula also. This one, x1 and x2 and y1 and y2, right? So as we know, x1 by y1 is equals to x2 by y2, where 40 by 12 is equals to 50,000 by 3 by x, right? Now, I am taking this x here and this 12 that side. So, it becomes, so we are writing here, so, or we can write in another method also, just erase this one. This is y2. So this can be written as x1 y2 is equal to x2 by 1, right? So x1 is 14, y2 is this one, right? Into x, which will be equals to x2 is 50,000 by 3, 50,000 by 3 into y1 is 12, into 12. So 3 ones, 3 fours, 12, right? So 40x is equal to 50,000 into 4 by, okay, yes, yes. Now x is equal to 50,000 into 4 by 40. 0, 0 cancel, 4, 4 cancel, and the remaining is 5,000, which is x. So what is x? Here, right? Write down the last step. Therefore, weight of 5,000, x is 5,000, put here 5,000. Weight of 5,000 sheets of thick paper is, weight of 5,000 sheets of thick paper is 16 2 by 3 kilograms. Right? Done. So this is our first sum for today. Let's see the other one. Ask me any doubts if you have. Hope it is very clear. A train moves at a constant speed of 75 kilometers per hour. The train is moving at a constant speed of 75 kilometers per hour. So first one, how far will it travel in 20 minutes? If it is going per hour, per 1 hour it is going 75 kilometers, and for 20 minutes how long it goes? The question, right? So let us see. Speed of train for 1 hour is equal to 75 kilometers. Right? Next. We need to find out the distance, how long it traveled for 20 minutes. So distance of train for 20 minutes is equals to, as we don't know, we'll take it as x. Again, write in a tabular form, okay? Time and distance. Time and distance. X1, y1, sorry. X1, x2. Y1, Y2. So a time for 1 hour, right? It is 1 hour traveling 75 kilometers. For 20 minutes, we don't know. It will be x. We know that this is, as this is in minutes, this should be also in minutes. For 1 hour, how many minutes? 60 minutes. So we can write here, the place of 1 hour, 1 hour or 60 minutes, right? For 60 minutes traveling 75 kilometers, for 20 minutes how long it travels? So we have a formula again. X1 by Y1 is equals to X2 by Y2, where X1 by 2 is equals to X2 by 1. Now, x1 is 60 minutes, y2 is x, 60 into x is equals to, x2 is 20 minutes, next, y1 is 75, this is 20 into 75, don't get confused. Now, x is equals to 20 into 75 by 60, 20 months, 23s, 3 months, 3 to 6, and 1, 3 5 is 15. X is equals to 25. Right? X is equals to 25. So here we got as 25 kilometers. Right? 60 minutes it is traveling 75 kilometers. For 20 minutes it is traveling 25 kilometers. Write down therefore distance of train for 20 minutes. Distance or traveled, you can write. You can have traveled also. Distance traveled by train in 20 minutes is equals to 25 kilometers. Okay? Okay. In this we have one more sum, second one. That will be your homework. Find the time required to cover a distance of 250 kilometers. So, same speed of train for 1 hour is equal to 75 kilometers. Next, you will write here time taken by train. Again, how you will write, you need to do it on your own. Okay, we'll do one thing. The second sum will be your homework. Do it and try to write down the steps. Okay, as you can, I will tell you, I will check if it is good. If you write it well, that is good. If not, I will be explaining the second one in the next session. It will be mostly very similar. The only steps will be changed. And the time will be 1 hour. And this is 75 kilometers. Here we have taken here x. But the second one you will take here x. Here as he is given 250 kilometers. So you need to change that. Try and do. Okay. We'll see next sum. 10th one now. Let's see then one. The design of a microchip has a scale of 40:1. Design of a microchip or let us write as scale of design of a microchip is equal to 40:1. Okay? So I'll explain, don't worry. So what he's saying, as we know, you know microchip, right? Microchip is very, very tiny. Everywhere we are using now. Mobiles, laptops, everywhere microchip is using, even in watches also microchip will be used. So microchip will be very very tiny, very very small. Micro itself is small. Micro antenna is chinnadi nadam. Okay. So he's saying that the designs, just a design. Design ante. So I will explain this in Telugu for you. See, manaki microchip annadi, if you see, it will be very very small. Not even this much size. It will be not even an inch. Okay. So very very small. మనకి డైరెక్ట్ గా వచ్చేసరికి అది చాలా చిన్నదిగా ఉంటుంది. బట్ వెన్ దే డిజైన్ ఇట్ విల్ బి వెరీ వెరీ లార్జర్, రైట్? విల్ బి చాలా పెద్దగా ఉంటుంది డిజైన్ కదా. మన మొబైల్ బుక్ లో డ్రా చేసుకున్నప్పుడు విల్ డ్రా ఇట్ వెరీ బిగ్. వెన్ ఇట్ కమ్స్ ఇన్ రియల్ ఇట్ విల్ బికమ్స్ వెరీ వెరీ స్మాల్, వెరీ టైనీ. సో వాట్ ఈస్ సేయింగ్ ద డిజైన్, ఈ డిజైన్ ఎలా ఉంటుంది అంటే ఇట్ ఇస్ సేయింగ్ దట్ రియల్ గా లెంత్ 1 సెంటీమీటర్ ఉంటే, రియల్ గా 1 సెంటీమీటర్ లెంత్ ఉంటే ఈ డిజైన్ లో మాత్రం 40 సెంటీమీటర్స్ ఉంటుంది. దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ద రేషియో, ద స్కేల్ ఈస్ 40:1 అంటే రియల్ గా 1 సెంటీమీటర్ ఉంటే డిజైన్ లో మాత్రం 40 సెంటీమీటర్స్ ఉంటుంది అని చెప్తున్నాడు. సో ఇన్ దాట్ ప్యాటర్న్, సో ఇన్ దాట్ ప్యాటర్న్ ఈ సేయింగ్ దట్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ద డిజైన్ length of design is equal to 18 centimeters. So ee design manam chestunnamo aa design lo length vachi 18 centimeters undi. But is asking us to find out the actual length of microscope. Design lo 18 centimeters unde real ga vache sariki enta avutundi? Actual length of microchip is equals to, as we don't know, we are considering it as x centimeters. Okay, x centimeters. So let's see, let's write it in a tabular form. So design, okay, and length. Design and length. So in design it is 40, in real life it will be 1. So when he is given the length of the design, if it is 18, then really it will be, we don't know, we have taken it as x, where x1, x2, y1, y2. x1 by y1 is equals to x2 by y2. x1 y2 is equals to x2 y1. Where x1 is 40, y2 is x, x2 is 18, y1 is 1. Now, x is equals to 18 by 40. So, which table we can use here? 2 9s, 18, 2 20s, which will be 9 by 20, 9 by 20 centimeters. X is equals to 9 by 20 centimeters. Right? Got it right? So this is the third sum. If you want, you can draw the answer. So 10.1 exercise is 9 by 20 centimeters, right? Okay. Hope you understood this sum also. Right? So right on the last step, I'm writing here. Therefore, actual length of microchip. Actual length of microchip is equal to 9 by 20 centimeters. Right? Let's see the last sum. And with that, we can complete this exercise. So let's see the last sum. The average age of doctors and lawyers together is 40. He's saying the average age. Average age of doctors and lawyers is equals to 40. So doctors and lawyers average age is 40. If the doctor's average age is 35 and the lawyer's average age is 50. Doctor's average age is equals to, doctor's average age is 35. Lawyer's average age is equals to 40. He is asking us to find out in what ratio their ages are. Find the ratio of number of doctors to the number of lawyers. It's not ages. So he is asking us to find out the ratio of number of doctors and the number of lawyers. Okay, we need to find the ratio. One is the number. We have 20. What is the 1:2 ratio only. So, we have to ratio find out. So, first, lawyers and the number, doctors and the number, we have to tell you. Let doctors be, X. Okay, and lawyers be Y. Okay, let doctors be X and lawyers be Y. Now, so average of doctors average age is 35, he's saying, right? Now, total age of doctors. So, can you say total age of doctors? We know age, we assume that total number of doctors are X and one person age is 35, average you are saying. One person age is 35 is average, and total there are x doctors. So what will be the total age of doctors? 35 into x, which will be 35x. Similarly, total age of lawyers is equal to 40 into y, which is 40y. Now, we know that average age of doctors and lawyers is 40. So, how to find out average age of doctors and lawyers? Right. How to find out? So, we have a formula for that, right? How you calculate a percentage? Total number of subjects, total marks by total number of subjects. Similarly, total age. What is the total age? 35x, right? Total age of doctors is 35x. 35x plus 40y by how many there are total? Doctors are x and lawyers are y members, right? Doctors are x and lawyers are y. So we need to add them, which will be equal to 40. Now 35x plus 40y is equals to 40 into x plus y. 35x plus 40y is equal to 40 into x is 40x plus 40 into y is 40y. If I take this both to LHS, 35x plus 40y minus 40x minus 40y is equal to 0. 35x minus 40x is minus 5x. 40y minus 4. Sorry. Somewhere we went wrong. Okay. Lawyer's average age is 50. I'm sorry. This is 50 here. Lawyer's average age is 50, which will become, this will be 50y. And lawyer's average age, this will be 50y. And this will be 50y. This will be 50y. This will be 50y. Now, plus 50y minus 40y is plus 10y is equal to 0. Now, minus 5x is equal to minus 10y. I am taking this 10y to RHS, becomes minus 10y. Minus minus gets cancelled. Now what I am doing? I am taking this y, only y, to LHS and this 5 to RHS, which becomes, it remains x here. When this y comes here, becomes denominator, z equals to, here we have 10, and when this 5 goes to RHS, becomes denominator. 5 ones, 5 twos. So here what it became? X by y is equals to 2 by 1. So x by y can be written as x is to y is equals to 2 is to 1. Therefore, it's in the ratio of 2 is to 1. What is x? Doctors. Which means if the doctor's age is 2, the lawyer's age is 1. If the doctor's age is 4, the lawyer's age is 2. Okay? So in the ratio, it is in the ratio of 2 is to 1. అంటే వీళ్ళకి డబల్ ఉంటుంది, వాళ్ళకి ఎంత ఉంటే దానికి వీళ్ళకి డబల్ అవుతుంది. లాయర్స్ కి 10 ఉంది అనుకోండి, వీళ్ళకి ఎంత అవుతుంది? 20 అవుతుంది. లాయర్స్ కి 100 ఉంటే వీళ్ళకి 200. దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ రేషియో. సో ఫైనలీ వి గాట్ ద రేషియో ఆఫ్ ద నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ డాక్టర్స్, రైట్? ఫైండ్ ద రేషియో ఆఫ్ ద నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ డాక్టర్స్ టు ద నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ లాయర్స్, రైట్? ఆన్ ద లాస్ట్ డే దేర్ఫోర్ దట్ యు కెన్ రైట్ ఫ్రమ్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్, దేర్ఫోర్ ద రేషియో ఆఫ్ ది నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ డాక్టర్స్ టు ద నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ లాయర్స్ ఇస్ 2 is to 1. Nothing. He answers to find the ratio. Find the pieces. You can write the ratio of the number of doctors to the number of lawyers is 2 is to 1. So with this we have completed this exercise. Okay. And 9th bit, 2nd one is your sum. Try. If you can do that, do it. If not, I will be explaining you in the next session. Okay. Hope you understood. If you still have any doubts, just reach out to me. Thank you.